aka Phife Dawg, aka Shorty Black, aka Don Jones. Leave it at the beat.
It's obviously the 25th anniversary of People's Instinctive Travels. Is that something you're going to be celebrating?
Not really. Being that that's more of a group thing.
Yeah.
And I wasn't really on that album that much. So, I have no choice but to perform, like, a Can I Kick It or something like that. But, I wouldn't be... celebrating that too much.
Yeah, I heard you speaking to Giles on the weekend about Can I Kick It and how that isn't your favourite. What are your favourite tracks to perform that are Tribe tracks?
My favourite Tribe tracks to perform would be Can I Kick It, Walk Through Hell, War Tour, Check the Line, Find a Way, Electric Relaxation, you know. There's many of them, but Can I Kick It is definitely not one of them, but it's a fan favorite, so it has to be done, you know what I mean?
Yeah, and in terms of your solo stuff, can we expect new stuff that's been unheard?
Yes, expect new stuff that you haven't heard.
And what's, you obviously had Dear Dilla out last year, which was a really phenomenal video and statement. Is the new material, have you done that with Rasta Roots as well? Is it a similar vibe?
Yep. I've recorded with Rasta Roots for some new things, as well as other producers that you haven't heard of yet, and as well as producers that you're familiar with, like Ninth Wonder and Crisis and some other people, but I don't want to give the whole thing away just yet.
Yeah.
You know.
Have you got a time scale for the release of future work?
Probably drop a new single in the fall and drop the album either probably the top of next year, end of this year or top of next year.
Fantastic. With your health, how is that? Are you in good health at the moment? Is it a pain to come and travel to the UK?
I'm in decent health. I just have to pick my battles. You know what I mean? Here and there. But I'm pretty decent. You know, if I wasn't, I wouldn't decide to come all the way overseas. You know what I mean? So, everything is cool.
Excellent. And do you find talking about your health, does that strike too much of a personal note? Or have you been quite happy with how you've kind of spread the word about...
I mean, I don't talk about it as much right now because I said what I needed to say, I guess, in the documentary, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, it's out there, everybody pretty much knows, so I pretty much look at it as old news at this point.
Okay. And has there been, obviously the documentary was a couple of years back now, but has there been, is that all that you hear now? Do people approach you about the documentary? Is that what Tribe is, the sort of the young generation now, do you think?
I think it is to a certain extent, but I don't get approached about it too much anymore. You know what I mean? They just, for those that aren't that familiar with the Tribe, but they might approach me and say, aren't you that guy from that group, or, you know, something like that. But I don't get approached about it too much.
Yeah. Back when you were doing the first album, I know you had a plan to work with Jairobi together. What do you think that would have looked like now? Do you think that would have been a successful collaboration that would have carried on for years and years?
Oh, I have absolutely no idea. But all I know is that we wouldn't have a window of opportunity to do anything if it wasn't for the group effort, if it wasn't for a Chop Ball Quest. So, you know, at the end of the day, all things happen for a reason. And I really have no regrets, you know?
Yeah. And is Jairobi still very much a part of the family then?
As far as the Tribe Called Quest?
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. No.
Could you offer any advice to new artists that are coming up in terms of, you know, 25 years ago was a very different period in terms of not having the internet and the way that record labels are run. Do you think that independent artists coming up now should just, you know, do it for themselves, or do they still need to look to record labels?
It depends on the individual. It depends on the person. It depends on the products out there, they don't think they can accomplish this, that, and the other thing, then I guess go with the labels. You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, don't quit your day job. If this music is going to get in your heart, you're going to be in for a rude awakening. You know what I mean? So definitely don't quit your day job if you're not ready for it. And you definitely have to have tough skin, especially with social media being 95% of what's going on right now. You know what I mean? So be able to handle everybody not liking your material, things of that nature. Be able to handle being talked about, things of that nature.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, you know.
Have you encountered any of that over Twitter, for instance, or is it a mostly positive vibe?
I've encountered the best of both worlds.
All right.
You know, the good, the bad, it's different. You know what I mean? So it really doesn't worry me at the end of the day, you know, but I've been doing this for too long. But if you're not prepared for that type of thing, it can really hit you from your blind side. You can really stumble or get bounced down from it. It's all about, are you able to get back up? No.
Yeah, and I've run a hip-hop night the past few years, and the young kids that have come along have been like 15, 16, 18, and their major influence has not been modern hip-hop artists, but it's been A Tribe Called Quest. Can you, if you had to summarise the influence that first album had and the band, how would you summarise that to someone that was very young that hadn't heard of the group? I mean, what is it about Tribe that people keep going back to?
I mean, that's a really good question. I don't know. I'm just thankful at the end of the day that we're still relevant, being that we haven't dropped an album since 1998. You know what I mean? And people treat us like we have the newest music out there right now, and there's so many people that are doing their thing right now, like a J. Cole or Kendrick Lamar and so forth, and they still want to hear Tribe at the end of the day. That's pretty amazing to me. So I'm just thankful. I really don't know why, but I'm just thankful, you know?
Thank you so much, Phife.
No problem.
Okay, you take care.
All right, you too.
Thank you.
All right. Peace. One love.
Relax yourself, girl, be set to air. Relax yourself, girl, be set to air. Relax yourself, girl, be set to air. Relax yourself, girl, be set to air.